Chris Wesselingh here from New Zealand. I'm here with Shiye. I'm finding myself almost speechless. The feeling of the earth here, like I'm looking at this earth and it feels alive, even though there's not a lot of plants growing out. And a lot of this feeling to me of aliveness comes from the attitude that people live with the land here, something we miss in Western society. Like, it feels not intruded upon. It's like the things we have around us here belong here. Everything's been invited or created here in a way that it lives together. And I haven't seen this in Western society ever. Not like this. You know, the houses aren't intruding upon the land. Like, we put them on the land. Here, they belong to the land, and it's like the land is a part of them. It's never a part of the land. And talking to you, so, yeah. Spoken to find somebody that lives with the land, which we desire to do so much, but have forgotten how. This is a way to come home to me. You know, this is, to me, is essentially where we belong. And I don't know how else to describe it. A living example of belonging with the land, you know, to me here. It's that heart connection that brings us home, and it shouldn't be a hard thing. Whereas here it's not. I feel the trees breathing, I feel the soil and its rhythm. It's like a heartbeat, it's a pulse. And it's here in everything. You know, the trees, the soil, even the houses have it. Because somehow, talking to Shiye, he's been explaining to me how it's just part of their life. Everything is respected. How would you put it?
Everything connected, respected. Pretty much that relationship, you could say. This life is like in a relationship,
yeah.
Where every day you walk with it and you show it and you acknowledge it and you do these little things for it, and in return it'll always give you and show you the beauty and the love eternally and externally.
Yeah,
you know,
that's a big thing, because I find the soil here at the moment talking, so this is the way we live, this is how to live. And some of us forgot that way. For me, it's a blessing to have a living example of it that I can feel, I can experience, I can take home. I still haven't got words for it. So, like with this video, I'm striving for words, but the words don't fit. It's not a word, it's not a description. It's a feeling, it's something, it's inside our hearts, a belonging, where the land belongs to me and I belong to the land. It's like a mutual support network or a life cycle. You can't step out of it here. Everywhere around here has got that living cycle, living energy. You can feel it.
Yeah.
When I go to big cities, it's like this. Connection's missing. The city's been built on the land and the land's been lost and forgotten. Whereas here it's old.
This my red sand. Take some with you. Take some with you. You know, put in a little bottle or something.
Yeah.
You know?
Thank you. Thank you very much. So that's gonna be my trip home with the red sand.
There you go. That starts, man. See? And well, I just wanna say thank you guys for coming to my home, being a part of it and experiencing it. Sharing your love, your heart, your energy, your knowledge, your medicine, your wisdom, you know, just you being in a presence, and, especially you know, you come all the way from New Zealand, and New Zealand is one of my favorite places in my heart too. I have in my heart, you know, as they say, it's the land of the rising sun, and I see the videos, I see the people there, and I see the culture, and it's beyond true, it's beauty, and it's an awakening. Can all rejoice and share, you know, once we get our hearts in that alignment.
one breath, not separate from the other, but co-joined, and even beyond co-joined, I don't know the words again. There's no separation. It's one breath, breathed by all being. And this I feel it here. Mm. I find it here. I can at home, but I usually have to get away from people. Whereas here, I don't. The people have got it. Thank you today for this.
Yeah, I hit it. Thank you.
Yeah.
Stay tuned for more. More will be coming. Love you all. Love these teachings.
I hope.